summer is golden.
Hi guys, it's Jessica Norman. This is Summer Golden. Just checking in. Look, I don't, like I said, I usually don't talk about products and everything, but come on now, Ford. You kidding me? They had this doggone radiator in here, like, it was like an open heart transplant. As you can see, the bolts are no longer here where the radiator was. I had to cut this off, because if you don't cut it off, there's no way. I wish I could show you that really, really. If you look down that canal, there's no way to get any tool that I've ever owned down that canal. I tried. I wanted to come back to show you. I ain't gonna go back. I dropped some wire down there, and I attached a ratchet to the bottom. To the rod to the ratchet, tried to pull it up to the bottom. It got stuck in between somewhere down in there. It got stuck. Anyway, I had to pull that out. I still got a couple of bolts that can fell out that tray area down here, so in the morning I'm gonna have to look for it a little further. But yeah, it was the intercooler. I'm so glad that it looks okay. It doesn't seem to be leaking or anything. And I couldn't get this front cooler off. I took the bolts out, I'm about to remember to tighten them, and it just won't come off. It's like they put this together so that you need to bring it back. You need to bring it back to them. And then I had transmission fluid coming out of that exchange. Cool the transmission fluid, and I put a number two pencil eraser in the end of it, and it broke off. So there's an eraser stuck in that one. But two big gulp cups full of transmission fluid came out of that line. I'm like, my God, is it really that low? So I know we got to get a couple of ports to ensure that we have the proper amount, you know, of transmission. We're gonna definitely put the same back that we took out, and I know it was a little bit low anyway, which probably made up for the. When they put the transmission in, they probably didn't add the extra port for the a couple of pictures of the serpentine belt in case we screw it up. That's the tensioner down there. We're going to get a tool and we're going to pop that, and then we'll take this alternator out tomorrow. We got a 130 amp. That will be a slight upgrade from our 95 amp here. As soon as we get things running properly, we'll be back in and get on the road. All right, guys, it's gonna be it for tonight. We'll see y'all tomorrow. Summer's golden. All right, fam. I know it's late, but I couldn't stop. I couldn't stop. We got it out, and we're on a roll here. And, you know, it's not that often you get on a roll. But it's Ford. What is up with these people? The last bolt on this alternator is so far back up in there. If you had a mechanical arm, you couldn't reach it. So I don't know how I'm gonna get it off. I'm gonna take these two front ones off and see if I can forcibly move the alternator back. Then I'll know to put that back one in first. This is ugly. I'll think twice before I fool around with this thing again. I'll be here this entire week. Well, it is the weekend though. Bye, y'all. Ladies, we flawless. Good morning, folks. Of course, I've been up a couple minutes. I couldn't let y'all look at me too ragtag. So we're gonna get out here. Oh, I'm so disappointed. And you know, I'm always disappointed with Ford when I try and fix it. I've had so many of them. God, it is the worst. That job should have been done yesterday.
Everybody knows that.
Ain't that right, Alan? So, job should have been done yesterday.
Oh, Lord.
Come on, let's sit down right here. I'm sorry. Alice and I have been trying to somewhat acclimate to being out in the field. So that's why we're here. We stepped in the... So any hooligan, we're going to get back on the project this morning. We've removed the radiator after a ton of effort. So I don't know if it was supposed to be that difficult, but it was. And we're just gonna move on from it. We have to. We had to cut one of the. You had to turn that thing off. It's not only loud, but it's hot. It's the exhaust. So, we had to cut one of the bolts off. The whole bolt system, actually. Because the way they built the frame, everything up there, and it doesn't matter what job you do on a Ford, it's gonna be taxing, more so than any other vehicle. So if somebody offers to fix it for you, let them fix it, because you're not gonna have any fun at all. And mechanics like the stuff that they do, so if they wanna fix your car, you should be on it. That says a lot of it. If a mechanic wants to fool with your car, maybe they feel Ford's challenging or something. But we're gonna knock that out. And I didn't realize that the temperature on my refrigerator is just not quite as cold as it reads. So it's not really freezing the food. The ice cream was just mush. I shouldn't even try to keep that. Bad thing to embark on the road with is any type of cream if you're lactose intolerant or even lactose disturbed, for the lack of the proper term. But yeah, I did, and I had some melty ice cream last night. So it's a good thing we're still close to base camp, because boy, that was quite the explosion. So rather than wait any longer, we're gonna get started. Sun's on that side of the roof, soon it'll be right above us. So the most we get done now, the cooler all this will be. So rather than run my mouth for the next 5 minutes, All right, for you folks who may disagree about Fords and everything, I looked at, this is the compartment where the radiator goes. And I looked this thing up and down, and there's no excuse for why that bolt could not have been placed on this side of the rail for easy removal. And they put it in there in such a way that if I had taken this out properly, everything on this front lift had to come off, to include the intercooler. And the only thing I had to do to circumvent that was to cut that top screw there off. That one right there. That's the only thing I had to do. Cut that off and came right out. So you could, that right there is an intentional manufacturer. I don't even want to call it a flaw. Somebody actually sat down and designed this vehicle in that manner, knowing, because you have to design it in such a way that you follow a process to show its assembly and disassembly. You know, in every one of these engineering projects. So of course they know that the screw is gonna have to be put in from the back or however. Probably was sequenced in such a way that the radiator, of course, was to be built prior to any of this being put on, which also shows how intentional that is, because you have to be aware then of the fact that all of this had to be put on after you put the radiator in, and you couldn't do it a different way unless you turned that screw around. That was terrible. Why did they do that? Oh, I'm sorry. Stupid question. That world that they make money in. Why do I say they? Because I don't make automobiles. stuff I do make don't make this kind of money. So. Anyway, we're debating whether or not we should put it back together or get that eraser out of the transmission inlet. Because if we don't get it at night, it could be even. Because it was difficult to do what I, once it's back in, I won't have any levers down there. Because I have to reach inside and get it. So if I gotta take it out first, I've got to come up with another container to catch the fluid that's clean. I'd like to keep it. Even though any little debris is not good for a transmission. We better rethink this. We might want to just buy new fluid. Yeah. Of course we already bought new antifreeze. So anyway, we're gonna go ahead and finish this thought, and then we'll go ahead and remember to put the fan guard back in first. Summer's golden. I had to turn the camera off because the oil was dripping onto the phone too excessively. But anyway, right as I was able to get an X-Acto knife, you see all that green? That's the eraser. Because as I tried to push that screw in there, the screw just pushed the eraser further and further in as I was trying to use it. And I knew then we were gonna be in big trouble if I didn't get that out of there. Because if it had went up into the line even further, we'd have had to replace the entire line. All right, let's get back to work. Oh, all right, fam. I'm back to talk about four. This is unreal. This is unreal. Do you know that, the simple act of flipping those clips for the radiator made it too short on the other side to put the other screws to those clips? It's that precisely malformed to make it so that you have no leeway whatsoever, that it absolutely has to be put on their way or the highway. I've never. But anyway, I know for a fact in my mind that by the time we get to the end and get down into these transmission lines, the way that they're gathered and aligned, I know that they're aligned perfectly for this radiator the way it's supposed to go. And if I deviate just a little, because they have them banded all along the way so that it's rigid, there's no flexibility whatsoever, I'm going to have to end up bending those to get them to work. And then when I bend it, I bet it's not going to work. I'm telling you, it's not just Ford. All of those newer cars, beyond 99 and 2000, you guys, boy. Hats off to all mechanics. I would not want to do this full time. All right, so I guess we've made a decision. Let's go ahead and widen the hole on the passenger side body, because there's a catch clip, but it's really an indention at the base of the radiator that catches a little clip. And on the passenger side, I've got clearance of about a quarter of an inch, whereas this one is not quite meeting its spot or the hole on the other side by maybe that much. So I don't have a choice, because if I go back the way I got them off, we can't put them back on that one. simply because, can I get your hand inside the area where the screw goes through the hole to be able to line it up correctly and screw it in first before putting your tool on it? But to remove it, the tool would, I had the flexible elbow ratchet, which enabled me to get it out. But putting it back, no. So we have to flip the clips. That's just it. The clips have to flip. I know I'm dehydrated, my back is splitting. So we're gonna get up and get out of here. I didn't want to use this whole day. My neighbor that came over invited me to cook out with him. I had my own plans of finishing this and going to the store and getting a couple things myself. But we'll see how this goes. If we get this done, I'll do that. If not, I won't. But anyway, that's what I'm doing. And I'll come back afterwards and let you know if it worked. I just did there is extremely dangerous because I was so close to the intercooler, and at one point I wasn't paying attention. I could have hit one of those lines with the coolant in it. You can only imagine. That would have been terrible. Another order, another several days of figuring out how to take it out and so forth. I'm gonna have to learn. It's all right to challenge yourself, but it's not a great idea to learn things all the time. Sometimes it's better to pay someone who knows what they're doing. And then that way, you know, you save tons of time. We'd be on the road in a couple days if it weren't for me. But any hooligan from Brooklyn? Thank you. bit excessive on the drilling, but it's really hard to get it back up out of there. Everything's so tight, and I don't want to take it back out, so I made the hole especially large to ensure that it fits this time. So we're going to let it cool, put it back in there, and I almost guarantee you it's going to fit. Guys, so much for jimmy rigging. I know you thought I was going to say something else. There's so much for it. That is what I've had to come up with. That's the bolt, or where the bolt that I cut off would have gone. And the best one that we can find, I know it's so much larger, which is going to defeat the purpose of enlarging that hole. As soon as I start putting it together, you'll see. I'll probably have to pull that out and pull a smaller screw in, something with a much smaller diameter there. And then on this side, it's looking like it might. We're going to see. I just wanted you to see my jimmy rig so that we could, we got to get this fluid from flowing. It's mad. In case you didn't know, the alternator went well. I didn't see any markings on there to determine whether it was 130 or 95, but clearly it was larger than the 95 amp that we just took off. And I believe I got the serpentine built. We're losing so much transmission fluid. We got to get out of here. We got to get out of here. This is ridiculous. Oh my goodness. I'm going to have to go buy a whole ton. But anyway, soon we get this back in here, we can hook up that line for that on that side, and it'll stop flowing. But alternator's in. I torqued it down last night when I was frustrated, so it should be good. So let's get this radiator in and we can. We just threw the new radiator in. Of course, we got the alternator on last night. We remembered to put the blade fan guard over it in first. but we were struggling with a clip on this side. Could not get the bolt to go in, like, you know, constant. And then I stopped and I pulled back and the ancestors showed me a clip that was on the cover. So I accidentally put it on the cover instead of the radiator. So I pulled that off, put it on the correct place. It went in pretty quickly. So all four screws in, batten down, cover batten. All we gotta do now, reassemble. Hey mommy, how you doing? I just gotta reassemble. That's my neighbor across the street, Miss Black. I'm cutting a video up while I'm fixing my alternator and radiator. Well, that's my neighbor across the street here, Miss Black. And so we're gonna finish this up here and hopefully we'll get thing running and probably have some air conditioning. How about that? So come along with us and we'll finish putting the transmission lines and the return on the radiator from the lock. See you downside. Blazing hip-hop and R&B out here today. But we've just about accomplished everything we set out to do, it seems. Alternator's on, belt's on, radiator's back in. Everything's plugged up. Just finishing the fill on the antifreeze. Pulling up the battery and we're going to go ahead and start it. So, here we go. okay, we'll check it tomorrow. I hope that's not gonna be a problem. We are getting ready to let it run. Turn the AC on, see what happens.
Mm-hmm.